you know, against the New World Order. I think a lot of these universities are going to, you know, we're just beginning this economic crisis, and it's, you know, a lot of these universities, when this economic crisis really gets going, you know, later this year into next year, but a lot of them are going to fail. And I think eventually with American Revolution II starting here, we're going to get new universities, or the ones that exist are going to be heavily modified. And I think our information, our voice, I think is the future there. So, I mean, I don't, you know, that I got fired from my job, really, I don't care. I've been teaching for 8 years, you know, all summer, a lot of classes. I'm anxious to take some time off. And plus, I don't really know where I fit in these schools anymore. I mean, these universities, they're not teaching empirical information. I mean, it's hard for people to understand this if you're not really in the university system paying attention to what's going on. But they're not, you know, you don't get into a class and sit there and tell your students, okay, I got this scientific article from this top journal and this scientific article from this and we're going to just debate these, and we're going to get to the bottom of things, and we're going to be empirical researchers. That almost never happens.
No, they teach you the German 200-year-old model of not learning how to think and learning how magical the world is and how things connect. It's all just by rote, regurgitating information.
Yeah, exactly. Well, they got these agendas. Like when I was teaching bioethics at Indiana University Northwest, which I was fired from, they wanted me to teach this bioethics class, and I said, okay, that sounds great. I'd love to. I didn't have a whole lot of background in it, but I said I'll do it because I could easily.
And it was really a eugenics class they wanted to teach you.
Yeah, they wanted me to teach eugenics, which, you know, it doesn't really exist.
By the way, we've never talked before. I just knew that because that's what they teach, but go ahead.
Yeah, no, right. Well, they wanted me to teach about euthanasia and all this stuff. And I said, you know, it's not really relevant. You know, I'm wasting the students' money, not really teaching them relevant information. So what I did is I just, on my own, got rid of that section of the class. And
added
the
whole section. Yeah, it's brainwashing. You pay 30 grand a year or whatever to go be brainwashed and taught a bunch of propaganda instead of information. Go ahead.
Yeah, it's absolutely unbelievable that people don't just wake up and say, what am I doing here? I mean, I take a calculus class, and we really only learn about four concepts the whole semester, and I never use any of this stuff ever again.
That's why I dropped out of college. It was like I'd go to math class, and it'd be how we've got to get rid of most of the population, guns are bad. I'd go to philosophy class, it was all New World Order. I'd go to Texas history, it'd all be New World Order. I'd go to U.S. history, it'd all be New World Order. It didn't matter what class, art class, it'd be New World Order. I mean, just everywhere, it's brainwashing.
Yeah, people don't pick up on this because they do it in a hidden way. No, they won't. Some classes won't talk about eugenics, so what they'll do is talk about global warming, and they'll act like everybody's in agreement. And you get the two students in the back who question it, and then you know all the rest of the students gang up against them. It's just people don't know. I mean, brainwashing in the universities is really
they're re-education
like the
camps. They're re-education military, same thing. Shaved heads, sleep deprivation, and this is what people don't understand. This is all 200 years old. It all comes out of Germany and England. And before education wasn't like this, but I mean, everything you're saying is true just because I've researched it myself. That's what's great about talking to somebody else who's researched this with your perspective. But we're going to come back and get more into your book, and I'm going to try to shut up and get into the corporatism, the secret government of the New World Order. It's published by Webster Tarpley's publisher, I thought I would add, so to give you an idea of the caliber of the material, and Progressive Press. So we really appreciate having you on the show with us. We're going to come right back to you after this break. But yeah, I mean, you pay after 12 years of your children being brainwashed to government schools to send them to another re-education camp. And folks, when I say re-education camp, they are re-education camps. I mean, re-education, Soviet Nazi system, that is what goes on at most universities. You got some good professors and teachers who aren't like that, but overall, it is a brainwashing mess. And they tried to recruit my dad into eugenics when he went to UT in the 60s.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. Did you know that the global elite are now storing non-hybrid seeds in secret storage vaults near the Arctic Circle? Did you know that in a real meltdown, non-hybrid seeds can become more valuable than silver or gold? It's true, seeds have outperformed even gold and silver before in this country, and it's possible that could even happen again. So our friends at Solutions from Science have put together the perfect mix of non-hybrid seeds. They call it a survival seed bank, and it can produce an endless supply of nutrient-dense food for you and your family. And here's the best part. These seeds have not been genetically modified in any way, and you actually get enough seeds to plant a full acre crisis garden. So visit them today at survivalseedbank.com. That's survivalseedbank.com, or give them a call at 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Remember, in a real crisis, non-hybrid seeds are the ultimate barter item. This is Alex Jones for SurvivalSeedBank.com. In the New World Order's war against humanity, Barack Obama is the tip of the spear.
We've got to give them a stake in creating the kind of world order that I think all of us would like to see.
the Obama deception completely destroys the myth that Obama is working for the best interest of the American people.
Well, Obama's already fudging. Yeah, fudged since day one in this election.
If you have a demagogue with a fanatical mass movement of personality cultists who is imposing the program of a group of extreme bankers and finance oligarchs, that's fascist.
It's not about left or right. It's about a one-world government. This film documents who Obama works for, the lies he has told, and his real agenda. Get your copy of The Obama Deception today at InfoWars.com or download it in super high quality at PrisonPlanet.tv. The Obama Deception. The people strike back.
Jim Newcomer from Midas Resources. May 22nd, 2009. Gold opened this morning at $957.80. A 1 ounce gold coin can be purchased for $985.12, $492.56 for a half ounce, and $246.28 for the quarter ounce. That's $985.12, $492.56, and $246.28.
Bailout equals market distortions increase money supply while productivity is going down. Wall Street is receiving injections of liquidity while smaller companies are forced to concede. Companies too big to fail are now using the tax dollars to increase market share, paying fat dividends. Are you wondering why supplies of gold and silver coins are decreasing rapidly, leaving the public scrambling to accumulate what's left? Fiat currency's value is based on trust, fiscal responsibility. Is Congress and the White House acting responsibly, earning your trust, or is it time to ensure your hard-earned wealth? Midas Resources offers economic insurance, gold and silver coins, 800-686-2237. Do you believe that more bailout will solve our economic problems, or would you like to call Midas Resources at 1-800-686-2237? That's Midas Resources at 1-800-686-2237.
If we could all see the germs that we encounter each day, we might have a different outlook on how we view our surroundings. In the past, you may not have put too much thought into it, but with the current health risks in the world today, it's impossible to ignore it. There is a solution, and it's called Hazrid. Hazrid utilizes a fogging device that disinfects, sanitizes, and protects against influenza, viruses, bacteria, allergen, mold, and more. It's tough on germs, but not on children and pets. You'll receive the fogger, liquid concentrate, enough to make up to 32 gallons of germ-killing power, three respirators, goggles, protective suit, and heavy-duty gloves. Order right now at Hazrid.com, and you'll receive double the order of liquid concentrate. Or call 800-675-0323. That's 800-675-0323. Or visit Hazrid.com. That's H-A-Z-A-R-I-D. Protect, prepare. Get your Hazrid today.
No matter how hard you try, you can't stop us now. No matter how hard you try, you can't stop us now. We're the Renegades, and it's Atomic Age. It's Atomic Age, a Renegade.
Continue. Let's get into your book, Corporatism, The Secret Government of the New World Order.
Yeah, that book was written from 2003 to 2007. When 9/11 happened, I was deep in my academic studies, getting my master's degree, and I really didn't even pay attention. I actually tried as best as I could to ignore all politics. So I'd ignore everything about the world. I just thought it was a complete joke. I didn't want to pay attention. I just wanted to do my academic work. But then 2003 happened, March 20. Or I forgot exactly, maybe the 19th, when we invaded Iraq. I was sitting there in Applebee's with my father, having a happy little lunch, watching people of Baghdad get blown to bits. And that completely shocked me unbelievably. And from that point on, I've been distracted. My academic work has been distracted. And all I can really focus on is what exactly is going on in the world. And the book Corporatism is my process of trying to figure out what's going on in the world. And it took me 4 years to write. I basically researched it, you know, 100 hours a week or more. It took to getting that book to be completed. Of course, you're quoted in the book about 30 times, Alex, because I've been listening to you ever since 2003. And, you know, I've been listening to, I mean, where else am I going to get this information? You know, I mean, you guys report all this stuff. I mean, nobody, it's really hard to find any other good information. So, but the book is, I think, there's only one problem, I think, with it. You know, like you said the other day about the Obama deception, you know, after you finish something, you find out things you wish you added later. There's a couple things I wish I added later, but the book basically, to sum it up, is about how the secret government works. Secret government is basically invisible. I mean, people like Rockefeller and stuff are getting close to the core of it. But, you know, the people we see on TV, what I call the visible government, we're showing these people on TV, you know, Obama. You know, remember the election was happening, and we were basically told who to vote for. The public didn't even know who Ron Paul was until late in the game.
Yeah, they spent billions manufacturing this guy. That's prima facie evidence he's New World Order. Then all his advisors, now the policies, now the betrayals. I mean, you know, he comes out and says, I am against the